Hi all, welcome to my channel, welcome to John's Model Making. Today we've got pack 9 of the Mitsubishi Zero. Now, taking out the stages that we don't require for the aeroplane, they're all to do with the base. We're left with 72, 73, 74, 75 and 77. And in stage 72, all we've got is that underplate to fit. This little plate, it does tell us to fit it, but then we take it off later on, so I'm not bother putting it on. We'll also have a look at connecting up some rods for the ailerons and the rear landing wheel, so we can test them as well. And I think I'll go through the tests as well with the elevators. Was there something else? Oh, the rudder. I think we've already done them, but we can always do them again. But I'm going to be interested to see how the flaps work, because they work separately. They don't work together like that. They do that. So that'll be interesting to see how that works. Also, I think we've got to take the PCB off to fit the rod in the first place. And we've got a small part to fit on top to keep the rod in place. And then we put the PCB back on. Don't know why we couldn't do that in the last pack, but anyway. But that is as much as we need to do. Some of these parts look absolutely stunning. They're still in the packaging. This is the fuselage. We do get to put one side of the fuselage on completely. You'll notice there's no decals, but there is some detail on it. So the detail, the decals will come in another pack later on. So there's only three more packs left after this one, but we're getting there. It's looking brilliant, and the stand is so much more solid than the hashout one as well. We'll see that in a separate video, but anyway, let's get on with the build. Okay, so stage 72, we've got this panel here, which is plastic, quite a lot of detail on it. There's a couple of screw holes there and some location pegs here, four of. And it basically just fits in here like this. I'm going to make sure we don't damage anything on top. There we go, and just screw it in from the top side. Okay, now we need to just fit two screws, one here and one here, to secure that plate in place. There we go. Why is that in place? Excellent stuff. Oh, we do have this to fit, but we can do that later because we only have to take it off again. Let's move on to the next stage. Okay, for this one, we removed this arm off this servo motor, and we need the test board. Unplug H1, which has been removed, which is this one. And we'll connect this up and we'll test that motor like that. And we can switch that on and center it, and it should hook it up. It seems that one of the batteries had gone, so that's the noise that you hear, and that should be centered now, so we can switch that off. Whilst we're here, we can check the operation of the elevators. There we go. That's centered, so that's that one checked. And the other one was this one. We can also check, switch that on, this should be the rudder. Oh, that's not connected. There we go. But it is working, as you can see it. Okay, now we can have a look at the rudder working. Center that. There we go. Excellent stuff. Stop it. Center it again. Brilliant. That just tells me, check your batteries, John. Right, what we need to do now is to fit this piece back on that servo motor, connect the rod up to the aileron over here, and then we need to drop a bracket over the top and test the ailerons. But first of all, I need to take this board off, so bear with me. Okay, now we've got the PCB off. Move that to one side. Now I need to fit this rod into here. Keep that still. Not as easy as it looks. There you go. Put that in. Shaped differently than the other hooks, and this that needs to be up the other way up, not that way, but it does need to fit that in there and there, like that. That's easy. There we go. So that's supposed to work. I can see it here. So here. Now I just need to put the PCB back in place. Or PCB, I should say. Okay, now the PCB is back in place. We can test this. We can test the ailerons now. Right, center that. There we go. Stop it, and oh, there we go. That should be better. That's centered. There it is. Brilliant. That's excellent. So we know the ailerons are working fine. And silly old me, forgot to add this block. As you can see, there's a cutout there for that rod, and we got two screw holes and two screw mounts there. Mounting points. Just fit it there like that, and we can screw that down. Then I'll put the PCB back. That's the first one. So we're going at a bit of an angle. What's the second one in place? Excellent. There we go. You see it there? Brilliant. Now I'll put the PCB back. Okay, let's give them a final test. Center it. There we go. You can see both ailerons moving up and down. Stop that there anywhere. And it should center. There we go, it's centered. I think my batteries must be a little weak. Anyway, let's move on. Okay, stage 74. We have these parts to fit. This is the frame for the fuselage, and we have this rod to fit as well for the rear landing wheel, I should say. I don't know how I'm saying gear. We'll fit this last. First of all, we'll do this rod. Okay, to get this rod in place, first of all we have to remove a bracket which is under here. It's not an easy place to get that. Pop that up. So I'll take this bracket off. And then we'll get the rod in place. It does hinder getting it in. There we go, that's the bracket off. And basically this rod fits in there like so, and also fits in here. Whether you can see that or not, you can see the rod here. It comes all the way along, so from that motor there to here, and then we need to fit this bracket back in place. It has a location peg as well on it, so it will only go one way. Okie doke. Now we've got the top screw in, we'll get the bottom screw in of this bracket. There we go. Can be a little bit awkward. There we go, you can see the bracket in place and you can see the rod all the way across. Excellent stuff. Okay, now we've done that, all these cables are now connected up to the PCB, and we now can connect this frame and capture all them. So every socket has been taken up by something, and now time to put this on. Okay, so this frame on this side can go on first, because these points here come through holes in the metalwork, and we then can connect the other side up. So that goes there, like that. We can push the cables to tidy them up afterwards. And this basically goes over the top and screws in there. Four screws. There we go. That's that frame. There's more screw mounting points here, here and here. There's six, so that'll be for the outer skin. But that's how that looks at the moment. There's the overhead. That is really coming together now. Excellent stuff. Okay, we can pop that to one side just for now. Grab all of these parts that came this stage. Use some detail. That is for the rear of the plane, and this is all metal. Look at that, that is beautiful. All we need to do with this is to fit these small components, some detail basically. So it goes in here. Like that. Hold that there. And then this will go over the top. That's right. That goes on like that. Should hold that piece in place. There we go. Press that down. Okay, there we go. There's that little piece. It is movable. I have to get my knife on the to push it that way, or you could push the top. There you can see, and it just moves back in place. Excellent. That's stage 74 complete. Okay, now we've got stage 75, the other part of the fuselage to fit. There's a lens. That's metal. And the rest of this is metal as well. Feed them screws. Now there is some nice detail on here, as you can see here. Again, no decals. So what we do, we marry these two up. Yep, I'm gonna hook it round there like that. Like that, and screw it in place. And two of these screws. This is going to look absolutely stunning when this is on. I might need some oil for this. Give me a little trusty egg cup. Change camera. Those are two big flange screws. There we go. That's what that looks like. Brilliant. Way up, is that way up? There we go. Right, we can fit this onto the plane now. Okay, I've sussed this now. Basically, we need to fit that like that there and bring that around there, like so. Doesn't look nothing like that in the instructions. And this needs to come around the front. To tidy them wires. Well, that's where it's supposed to go, like that. That's easy. Well, we're gonna have a look at these wires, see what's what here before trapping anything. Oh, there we go, that's that in place. It was a little bit fiddly, there was one or two wires getting in the way as well, but I've redressed them and positions that it's supposed to be at, it is at. Let me have a look at the other camera. There we go. Just adjust this camera, won't be a sec. Okie doke, there we go. Now I just need to have a look at the instructions, see if we screw it in. And there's a point at the front that we actually screw in place. I'll just leave that there for now. That piece comes down all the time. Gravity for you. Okay, it asks us to fit this lens for the rear navigation light. Get that out of the packet. That goes here. Just there, along here. There's a push fit. There's two holes on that there, and it will go eventually. So get around there like that. I just need to push it into place. Just give us a sec. Not easy balancing this like this, but there it is, there's the lens in place. It was just a push bit. Obviously I've got to balance this. There we go, that's a better shot. There we go. Excellent stuff. Now all we need to do is one screw at the front here. keep this frame in place. There it is. There we go. Got it. There we go. Excellent stuff. Right, so there we go. That is that stage completed. There we go. Can we see that now fine? Try it on another camera. There we go. That's a bit better. That looks fantastic, that. Absolutely brilliant. Oh, well, at least we know the rudder works, the elevators work, the ailerons work. Not tried the landing gear as yet, so it doesn't ask us to do that just yet. But anyway, let's move on to last stage. Pop that to the front there. Basically, this last stage, just asking us to check the components that we got inside. That is it for this month. Okay, let's have a quick look. There we go, there's the plane. You see the fuselage on in place. This is all nicely butted up and screwed in at the front. That is looking fantastic. There was a panel to go on here as well. That is that, that goes on there, something like that. And but I'll leave that off because I'm sure we actually take that off at a later stage. We've got the other parts of the fuselage to fit. Obviously we've got the front part, but we need the rear part. And that is that for this month. But as you can see, it's coming on fantastic. And you saw the electrics work with the servo motors. It's just a pity my batteries are a bit duff. But it's where it goes. One of the batteries that was actually reading virtually zero. But it is what it is. Anyway, if you did like that, give us a big thumbs up, subscribe and hit that notification bell. And I will see you next month for Pike 10. Now, like I said before, the other stages for the base, I'm going to do a separate video, which is coming along nicely. This month I did receive a bottom panel, which should have been, I should have received in Pike 10. So the part that I should have received in Pike 9, I've had to order. I've let Agora know and they're sending a replacement. So just gotta wait for that now. But anyway, until next month, thanks for watching. Stay safe, I'll see you soon. Bye for now.